Subject code is CS451 compiler design. Today we will discuss about the syntax analysis. In the previous two lectures, we have discussed about the introduction of the compiler and the lexical analysis. And today we will discuss syntax analysis. See, these are the course outlines. Here today we will discuss about the roles of the parser, derivation and parse tree, ambiguous grammar, parsing techniques, top-down parser, bottom-up parser, introduction to LR parsing. In this lecture, we will discuss about the role of the parser, derivation and parsing tree, ambiguous grammar, parsing techniques. See, what is the role of the parser? A parsing or syntax tree is the process which takes the input string and produce either a parse tree or generate the syntactic error. We know that in the lexical analysis, what is the role of this lexical analysis? We have discussed in the last class. Here we have the source program or character string. The lexical analyzer, it converts the source string into the tokens. That are the input of the parser. Parser means syntax analyzer. Here it accepts the tokens and generates the hierarchical structure. That hierarchical structure is called parse tree or syntax tree. And if there is an error, then it shows the error. So that is the role of the parser. We know what is the role of the simpleton, and we have already discussed in the previous class. Function of the parser. Its main function is to take the tokens from the lexical analyzer and group them in such a way that some programming structure can be recognized. After grouping the tokens, if any syntax cannot be recognized, then syntactic error will be generated. The parser collects sufficient number of tokens and build a parse tree. Thus, by building a parse tree, parser finds the syntactic error, if any. Derivation tree. What is the means of derivation tree? G is the context-free grammar which contains four tuples V, T, P, S. V is the set of vertices, T is the terminals, and P is the set of production rules, S is the starting points. So here the derivation tree is a tree which can be constructed by the following property. It contains a root that has the label S. Every vertex can be derived from V union T union N. If there exists a vertex A with children R1, R2 up to Rn, then there should be a production A is R1, R2 up to Rn. The leaf node are from set T and interior node are from set B. Next is the type of the derivation tree. In the previous course, CS358, Theory of Computation, we have already discussed about the derivation tree. We know that there are two types of derivation tree. One is the leftmost derivation, another is the rightmost derivation. Now see, what is the difference between leftmost derivation and rightmost derivation? In the leftmost derivation, non-terminal in each sentinel is always chosen first for the replacement. So, in the rightmost derivation, the rightmost non-terminal in each sentinel is always chosen first from the replacement. Now, see the example. This project. See, let G be a grammar being a context free grammar which the production rule one given below S is A B B A H A A S B A A and B H B B S A B string is A A A B B A B B B A. See the leftmost derivation. Leftmost derivation tree. According to the definition, we know that S is the starting symbol. So we will start from the S. S is, for the S, we have two rules. One is AB and another is BA. Our first letter in the string is A. We want to prepare the derivation tree for this string. So we will select the rule AB. Then next is, again we have A, so we will derive from the leftmost variables. Here leftmost variable is B. C, from the B we have the rule ABB, so we will apply this rule AABB. Then again we require A, so we will use the same, again the same rule ABBB. Next, for this B, we want B. So we have a rule AAA BSB. Here, now we have this A, this B. Next, we want B. For the S, what is the rule related to B? So that is BA. So AAA B BA BB. Again, the leftmost variable is this A. This we have this B. Now, C, for this A, what is A? So that is A. AAA B B A B B. Now this A is over. Then we require B. So what is the rule related to B? This is the leftmost variable. So we will use the rule for this AAA BB A. This is B and B. This B is also over. Next is this B. Now see what is the rule related to this B. Here we will use AAA BBAB. Here for B we will use this BS. So we also have this B. For this S, this is the leftmost variable AAA BBAB. For this S we have BA. Then this is the leftmost variable, so we will use AAA BBA BBBA. In this way we can derive the leftmost derivation. So this is the leftmost derivation. Now for the same string we will derive from the rightmost. Again the same is AB. Next, we have this A. Here the rightmost variable is B. Apply the rule, same rule, AA BB. Same rule, AA BB. Again, for this B, this is the rightmost variable. This A, we also have this A. Next is AA B. For this B, this is the rightmost variable, so we can write BS. BS. Then we can write, then this is BS, then AA B B. For this B, we can write BA. This is the rightmost, so we can write SABA. This is the rightmost, so we can write AAB BBA. Now see, this A BB, this also includes in the string. Next is for this B, this is the rightmost, so here we will use the next rule. Here we require this A, so we will use the rules related to the A. So naturally A B B B A. This is the rightmost variable. This also A. Next, here we want the derivation for this B. Here we can put the B. B. For this B, we have B, so we can write B B B A. So this B is also over. Now for this B, here we require B, so we will write the rule related to B. So B for B S. B B B A. Then the next is for this S. Again we have the rule for the B. S means B A. A A A. B B A. B B B A. Now this is A. So A A A. B B A. B B B A. In this way we can prepare we can derive the leftmost and rightmost derivation for the particular string. If we have the context tree now, then what is the parse tree? See the parse tree for the leftmost derivation. S is the starting symbol. S is the starting symbol. First is AB. So A. Then B. For this B, we use ABB. So this is A, B, and this B. Then again for this B, we use A, B, B. Next for this B, this is BS, B, S. This is BS. Then for this S, then for this S, S is BA. So this is B and this A. And for this A, then A. For this B, we use this B. For this B, then BS. Then for this S, BA, and then A. This is the leftmost derivation tree. Then the rightmost derivation starts from the S. S. First rule is AB. AB. Next is for this B, ABB, then for this B, BS, then for this, this is BS, so this BS, then for this S, BA, so that is BA, and for this A, so that is A. Here, for this B, ABB, ABB, then for this B, so that is B, for this, so that is BS, and for this S, BA, BA, and this A. Then AB, so this is the leftmost and rightmost ridge. Next is ambiguity or ambiguous grammar. Already discussed in the previous course what is the ambiguous grammar. If the grammar generates more than one parse tree for the sentence of the language G. Here, see, for this language S is AB, AAB, A is A, AA, and B is B, and see this grammar is ambiguous or not. So here, first see a language that belongs to this grammar. Here, now suppose the language is AA. Now suppose the language is AAB. Here we will use more than one. Here we have these production rules. Now we will try to make the more than one parse tree. So here first we apply S is AB. First production S is AB. For this A, here S is AB. For this variable A, if we use AA, and for this A, this B, for this B. So this is the one derivation tree. Now use the another rule. S is AAB, AAB, and for this B, this B. Here for the same language AAB, we use this production rules, and it generates more than one parse tree. So we can say this is the ambiguous grammar. Parsing techniques. So these are the parsing techniques. So there are two types of parser. One is top down parser, second is bottom up parser. So top down parser, backtracking and predictive parser. In the bottom up, shift reduce parser and LR parser. In these LR parser are divided in three parts. One is the SLR, LALR and LR. So first, top down parser. You from the name, it is clear that in the top down parsing, the parse tree is generated from the top to bottom. The derivation terminates when the required input string terminates. The leftmost derivation tree matches this requirement. The main task is to find the appropriate production rule in order to produce the correct input string. Next is top-down parsing. Here, see the example. Suppose we have the production rules. T is T E dash. E dash is plus T E dash empty. T is F T dash. T dash F T dash and F is E I. String is id plus id multiply id. See the top down parsing start from the initial, so that is e. Leftmost derivation for this e, so there is only one variable, so for this variable there is a rule, e is t e dash. Again the leftmost, so here what is the leftmost variable? T is the leftmost variable. Now see the rules for this T. Here we want this string, so for this T we have a rule F T dash, so apply this rule E T E dash for this F T dash. Next, again the leftmost. So what is the leftmost? F is the leftmost. For this F, we have ID. We have a rule ID. So apply this rule. E T E dash F T dash. This is ID. So we have this ID. Next, we want this plus. Next variable is t dash. Here we want plus, so we can't get from this t dash. So apply a rule that is related to this plus. In the t dash, we have multiply. So we will apply the rule, so that is null. So for the leftmost derivation, e t e dash, this is f t dash. Here id, here this is null. Next, e dash is the leftmost variable. So see the rule related to e dash. Here we want plus t e dash, so we can write e dash f t dash. This is id. This is this, and here this is plus t t dash. Next, leftmost derivation. Here, this t is the leftmost variable. This plus is also have. Now we want id. So see the rules related to t. T E dash F T dash, this is ID, this is null, this is plus, this is T, this is E dash. For this T, there is a rule F T dash. F T dash and for this F, again we know this is the leftmost variable, we can put ID. E T E dash F T dash, this is plus T E dash This is ID. This is null. This is F. This is T dash. This is F. For this F, this is ID. So we have this ID. Next, leftmost derivation. So that is the T dash is the leftmost variable. So T E dash F T dash. This is plus T E dash. This is ID. This is empty. This is F T dash. This is ID. This is so for this T dash we know that we require this star, so we will use the rule related to this. Next, for this F E dash F E dash plus T E dash. This is ID, this is empty, this is F T dash, this is ID, this is multiplier, this is F, this is T dash, so this is ID. So multiply and this ID we have. Next, E dash F T dash plus T E dash, this is ID, this is null, this T F T dash, so this is ID, this is multiply F T dash, here this is ID, so we can put null. And finally, E dash F T dash plus T E dash, this is ID, this is null, this is F T dash, this is ID, this is multiply, this is F, this is T dash, this is ID, this is null, and this is also. So this is this type of parsing is called top down parsing. Next is problems with top-down parsing. What are the problems? First problem is backtracking. See what is the concept of backtracking. Backtracking is a technique in the expansion of non-terminal symbol. We choose one alternative, and if some mismatch occurs, then we try other alternative if any. In backtracking, we need to move some level upward in order to check the possibility, so that this increases a lot of overhead in implementation of parsing. See the example of backtracking. First problem, that is the backtracking. Now see the concept of backtracking. See the example. Now suppose the production is S is X, T, Z and P is Y, W and Y. Now suppose the string is X, Y, Z. String is x, y, z. We have a string x, y, z. We have these production rules. Now we want to construct the tree. So start from the initial starting symbol s, so that is x, p, z. Here these two are the terminals. Here p is the variable. See, for this variable we have two production rules. Now suppose if we apply this, so next step is this is the step 1. Next step, step 2. In this x, p, z. Now suppose if we apply y, w. For this string, we want to generate the string this. For this string, this production is not valid. So here we will backtrack. Here we will backtrack to the previous level. Here it means here. So in the step 3, S, X, P, Z. So here for the variable P, we will see the alternate rules. Here the another alternate is we can place this Y. So here we will place this Y. So this method to backtrack to the previous level, yeah, one level upward. So that is called backtracking. Next is left recursion. Left recursion. See, in the left recursion, if we have the production A is A alpha and beta. Now see the concept of left recursion. A is A alpha, A is A alpha. Now suppose the string is beta alpha alpha alpha. Now suppose we want to generate this string. Here again we will apply this A alpha, again A alpha, and then so this is the left recursion. We can eliminate the top down parser if it doesn't desire this type of left recursion. So we can remove the left recursion if G is a context free grammar having a production rule with the left recursion A is A alpha beta, then we can eliminate by this A is B beta A dash, A dash is alpha A dash, and this term. Here see, this A is beta A dash, A is beta A dash. Then A dash is alpha A dash, alpha A dash, and this alpha A dash, and this. Here this is the solution to eliminate the left recursion. See the example. See the example. Now suppose we have the grammar S is AAB, A is AC, AAB, BD, and this. Now see here, Now compare with this. Here there is no problem. This is not the left recursion. Here there is a recursion, left recursion. We want to remove this. Compare with this. A is A alpha. Compare with A is A alpha. So what is alpha 1 and what is alpha 2? Alpha 1 is C, alpha 2 is A. Then beta, here beta. So beta 1 is BD, beta 2 is null. So what is the solution? So what is the solution? Here A is beta 1 BD A1 A dash, then null A dash, it means A dash. A dash is alpha A dash. Alpha A dash means alpha. Alpha means C A dash and C A dash and A D A dash and so this is the solution. D D A dash C A dash A D A dash and this null and this is the and this S is AA. So this is the cell. So this is the left factor. Left recursion. So next is the left factor. Next is the left factoring. In the left factoring, now suppose the production are in this form. A is alpha beta 1 alpha beta 2. If a production, then it is not possible for us to take a decision whether to choose the first rule or the second rule. In this situation, the above grammar can be left factored as in this way. So now see the example. S is I E T S I E T S E S A E H. Now suppose this, now we want to remove the left factor, then we can eliminate the left factor by rewriting in this way. See here, for this S, now compare this S is I E T S I E T S E S and this A. Now see for this here. So what is alpha and what is alpha and what is beta? Here this is alpha. So alpha equal to I E T S and what is beta? Here the beta 1 equal to null and beta 2 equal to here this is ES. Beta 2 equal to ES. Now we can rewrite this in this way. S is alpha. So what is the value of this alpha? Alpha is I E T S S dash and S dash is beta 1. Beta 1 is empty and ears. And the rest of the things are S, A, and this E. So in this way, we can eliminate the left recursion from this to this. Left factoring, we can left factor in this way. Ambiguity. In the top-down parsing, the ambiguous grammar is not desirable. See the rule E is E plus E, E multiply E and ID. Now suppose the string is ID plus ID multiply ID. Now apply these two production rules. E is E plus E. Here in this case we apply E is E multiply E. For this E, this is ID. For this E, again E multiply E, and here ID, and here ID. Here this is E. Here you can apply E plus E. Here this is ID. Here this is ID, and this is ID. So again, there for this grammar, for this string, there are more than one production, one parse tree. So we can say this is the ambiguous grammar. So this ambiguous grammar is not desirable in the top-down parsing. So these are the four problems in the parsing, in the top-down parsing.